Hello everyone, in this video we're going to talk about parallel lines cut by a transversal line angle measures. Now for our learning target, we do have I can solve and identify the angle measures of parallel lines cut by a transversal. Now let's have the first test, find the measures of the rest of the angles given that measure of angle 1 is 155 degrees. So before we proceed, maybe it would be better for us to focus first with the illustration. So I have in here 155 degrees. So from this given angle measure, we can apply different or various angle relationship. But as for me, I'm going to apply the vertical angle first. So angle 1 and angle 4 are considered vertical angles. Hence, we can say that angle 4 is also 155 degrees. Now, let's proceed with angle 2. As you can see, the relationship exists between angle 1 and angle 2 is linear pair. Or we can also have angle 2 and angle 4, they are linear pair. So that means the sum of the measures of angle 1 and angle 2 should be 180 degrees. So that means we're gonna have 180 minus 155, and that would be 25 degrees. Alright? And since angle 2 is 25 degrees, then we can say angle 3 is also 25 degrees. So by vertical angle, or else we can have supplementary angle or linear pair. So now let's proceed with the lower portion of our parallel lines cut by a transversal. Now here we can apply various relationship as well, but as for me, I'm going to apply alternate interior angle. So angle 4 and angle 5 are alternate interior angles, hence we can say that they do have congruent angle measure. So that means angle 5 will be 155 degrees as well. As for angle 6, this should be congruent with angle 3 because they are alternate interior angles. So from here, we can also apply corresponding angles, alternate interior angles, or alternate exterior angles, I mean, same side exterior angles, or any other relationship. But as for me, I'm going to apply the simplest one, which is vertical angle. So angle 6 and angle 7, they are considered vertical angles. Hence, angle 7 is also 25 degrees. And on the other hand, angle 8 will be 155 degrees as well, since angle 5 and angle 8 are considered vertical angles. Now, so since we're done already identifying the angle measures of each angle form in here, so we may now organize our answers, final answers in here. So measure of angle 2 will be this one, so 25 degrees. Okay, take note to write always the unit of measurement for angle measure, and that would be degree. Next, for angle 3, we do have this, which is also 25 degrees. Alright, and for angle 4, this one, we do have 155 degrees. And for angle 1, we do have, for angle 5, we do have 155 degrees. So for angle 5, we have here. And for angle 6, we do have 25 degrees. Okay, and for angle 7, we do have 25 degrees. And lastly, for angle 8, we do have 155 degrees. So that means we are done with task number 1. Now, let's proceed with task number 2. Okay, let's ponder. What if we do have these two transversal lines? We do have supposedly angle M, line M and line N are parallel lines. So as you can see, we do have two transversal lines, line A and line B. Alright, so what if this is the given illustration? So based on our given data, it is mentioned that measure of angle 3 is 77 degrees. So this one is 77 degrees. And for measure of angle 14, this measures 143 degrees. So even though we do have two transversal lines in here, one thing I would like to share to you is that you focus on one given first. So since we do have 77 degrees for angle 3, let us focus first with the transversal line, which is line B. So for the meantime, you disregard the transversal line A. Okay, now let's proceed. So since angle 3 is 77, that means angle 12 is 77 degrees as well. Now, again, since angle 3 and angle 4 in here, the relationship exists is linear pair or supplementary, then we can say that their sum should be 180 degrees. So 180 minus 77, that would be 103 degrees. So angle 4 and angle 11 are vertical angles, then definitely angle 11 should be 103 degrees as well. So moving on to the next portion. So alternate interior angles are congruent. So that means angle 7, the alternate interior angles that we have would be angle 7 and angle 12, which means angle 7 has the same measure with angle 12, while angle 8 has the same measure with angle 11, which is 103 degrees. Okay, and since angle 15 is vertical angle with angle 8, then we can say that it measures 103 degrees as well. Same manner with angle 16, it is considered a vertical angle of angle 7, then we can say that angle 16 is 77 degrees as well. Moving on to the next transversal line, and that would be line A. So it is given that angle 14 is 143 degrees. So from here, we all know angle 14, angle 15 are vertical angles. Then we can conclude that angle 5 is 143 degrees as well. And for angle 6 and 13, so we consider 143 degrees for angle 5. It is supplementary with angle 6. So that means angle 6 would be 37 degrees. So how did we get 37? 180 minus 143 degrees. So let's check. So we have 10 minus 3, it's 7. 7. 7 minus 4, we have 3. So that means it's 37 degrees. Okay. Now for angle 13, that would be 37 degrees as well, since it is vertical angle with angle 6. Okay, so lastly, at the upper portion of our parallel lines cut by a transversal. So since 143 degrees is the corresponding angle of angle 5, then angle 1 is 143 degrees as well. And angle 1 is vertical with angle 10. That means measure of angle 10 is 143 degrees. Or you may also use alternate interior angles. Since angle 5 is 143 degrees, then angle 10 is 143 degrees as well, since they are alternate interior angles. We all know alternate interior angles are also congruent angles. Now, going back, for angle 2, this is the corresponding angle of angle 6. So definitely this would be 37 degrees as well. Alright. And for angle 9, this is also 37 degrees since it is vertical with angle 2. Or you may have angle 9 is the alternate interior angles angle of angle 6. Then they do have the same measure, which is 37 degrees. So whichever relationship are you going to apply, you would arrive at the same answer, provided that you are able to integrate or apply the correct relationship between the angles. So take note, now this time we are going to list down all the answers that we've got. So from angle 1, so for angle 1, we have 143 degrees. So be careful. Now for angle 2, it's 37 degrees. For angle 4, that is 103 degrees. For angle 5, that is 143 degrees. For angle 6, it's 37 degrees. For angle 7, we do have 77 degrees. For angle 8, we do have 103 degrees. For angle 9, there's a lot, sorry. So for angle 9, we do have 37 degrees. For angle 10, we do have 143 degrees. For angle 11, we do have 103 degrees. For angle 12, we do have 77 degrees. For angle 14, we do have 143 degrees. For angle 15, we do have 103 degrees. And lastly, for angle 16, we do have 77 degrees. So that means we're done with this example. Now, let's identify the angle measures being asked in the illustration. So let's just focus on the highlighted part. Alright, so here, as you can see, the given data in here is 110 degrees, and you are asked to find this one. So in here, let's find out the relationship first of the angle being given and the angle that you are going to identify its measure. So the relationship is alternate exterior angles, and we all know alternate exterior angles have the same measure. So that means our answer for this item would be 110 degrees. All right. So next, how about in our second example? So we do have 84 degrees in here, and we are going to find this portion and what is the relationship that exists. So as you can see, they are alternate interior angles. So that means we would have the same measure again. Okay, so moving on for number three. So we do have 100 degrees, and this one is the missing angle measure. So what's the relationship between the two? As you can see, they are same side interior angles. And we all know that same side interior angles or same side exterior angles are supplementary. So definitely the sum of this angle and then another angle should give us 180 degrees. So definitely we're gonna have 180 minus the given, which is 100. So that means we'll have 80 degrees. All right, as easy as that. Now, how about this one? So let's identify again the relationship of the two. As you can see, they are alternate interior angles. So that means they do have the same measures. So it's 111 degrees. Moving on. So in this portion, we can see that they are alternate interior angles as well. So that means we're gonna have the same answer, which is 125 degrees, since alternate interior angles have the same measure. Now moving on to the next figure, as you can see, the relationship in here is alternate exterior angles. Hence, we can say that the two angles must be congruent. So that means our answer for this would be 47 degrees as well. Now, next figure. So what is the relationship of the two? So we can identify the relationship, which is corresponding angle. And we all know corresponding angles have the same measure or angle measure. So that means this one is also 53 degrees. Moving on to the next one, this 113 degrees, and this angle is actually alternate interior angles. Hence, we can say that they do have the same angle measure. Okay, and the next one, so how about this one? So we do have the highlighted given data, which is 90 degrees, and this one, which is 21x plus 6. So the relationship exists is alternate exterior angle. And we all know alternate exterior angles have the same measure. So that means we are gonna have 90 degrees as well for 21x plus 6. So we're gonna have 21x plus 6 equals 90 degrees as well. Or we can have this one, we can make it 21x plus 6 as well, since they are alternate exterior angles. We all know alternate exterior angles have the same measure. So definitely this one is equal to 90 degrees and this one is equal to 21x plus 6 as well. Alright? Now, next we have this portion and this portion. Okay, so now as you can see, the relationship of the two is corresponding angle. So that means we are gonna have our equation, which is 11x minus 2 equals 75 degrees. So if you wanted to find the value of x, simply use the properties of equality that we've discussed during your lower level or lower grades. Alright, so now let's proceed with the next figure. As you can see, the relationship between the two highlighted angles is alternate interior angles, and we all know alternate interior angles have the same measure. Okay, so that means 8x minus 4 is equal to 60 degrees, and this 60 degrees is also equal to 8x minus 4. Okay, again, if you would like to find the value of x, simply continue the process by applying the properties that was discussed to you previously. Alright, now moving on. So, in this scenario, still we can see alternate interior angles. Therefore, we can conclude that x plus 139 is also equal to 132 degrees. Alright, so let's be careful in creating such equation, especially if you are going to identify the value of x. So what if we're gonna have example, let's say we do have 11x equals 75 plus 2. So let's have the shortcut only, 11x equals 77. So 11x equals 77 divided by 11 there. So we're gonna have this is equal to x equals 7. So that means if you are asked by your teacher what will be the value of x, so that the two angles would be equal, so x should be 7. Okay, so same manner in this example, let's say we have 8x minus 4 equals 60. We needed to combine the like terms, so we're gonna have 60 plus 4, and that means we're gonna have 8x equals 64, and then divide both sides by 8 because we are only asked to find the value of 1x. Hence, we are going to come up with x equals 8. So this is our final answer. If, again, if you are asked to find the value of x. Moving on, for our last example, we do have x plus 139 equals 132. So now we are gonna have x equals 132 minus 139. So x is equal to negative 7. Okay, so that means the value of x that would make the equation true is negative 7. This should be negative 7. Anyway, we're just going to find the value of x. But again, generally or specifically, if we would like to present the angle measure of the angle, it should be positive. But in here, it's just a value of x to make the equation true or correct. So that means if you're going to check your answer, negative 7 is for x. So, negative 7 plus 139 is equal to 132. So, that is obviously correct. So, that means we got correct answer in here for the specific value of x only. Now, let us proceed with the last three examples that we have. We have, for the first one, we do have 20x plus 5 added with 24x minus 1 equals, since the relationship that exists between the two same side interior angles, we can conclude that they are supplementary. Hence, this should be equal to 180 degrees. Now, from here, we combine like terms. We're gonna have 44x plus 4 equals 180. How did we get 44x? 20x plus 24x, that's 44x. Positive 5 plus negative 1, that should be positive 4. Then, we're gonna have 44x equals, let's isolate first the term, which is a variable. So, we're gonna have 180 minus 4. Let's have the shortcut. So, 44x equals 176. We're not yet done because we are tasked to find out the value of x only. So, we divide both sides by 44 so that we will have a remaining answer of variable x, which is equal to 4. So, that means we are done with the first figure. Alright? So, now, let's proceed with figure number 2. So, as you can see, they are corresponding angles. And we all know corresponding angles are congruent. So, that means simply, let's gonna have 6x equals 5x plus 10. And from here, let's isolate the terms with the variables. And let's combine the like terms. So, we're gonna have x is equal to 10. So, we're done. So, if you would like to check, simply 6 times 10, 60. 5 times 10, it's 50. Plus 10, it's 60. So, they are both 60. So, that means that is correct because we are able to check our answers already. Next, x plus 109 and x plus 89. The relationship exists as same side interior angles, which concludes that they are supplementary. So, from that idea, let's create the equation that shows they are supplementary. So, again, by definition, if they are supplementary, simply add the two angles and it should be equal to 180 degrees. And then, from here, let's continue the process. So, we're gonna have combined like terms, which is 2x, and the 109 plus 89, that would be 198 equals 180 degrees. So from here, let's combine like terms. 180 degrees minus 198 degrees, we're gonna have negative 18 degrees. But we divide both sides by 2. Then we'll arrive with x is equal to negative 9. And if you are in doubt, since the value of the variable is negative, you may check directly in the given data. So, if x is negative 9, negative 9 plus 109 equals 100. How about here? Negative 9 plus 89 will have 80. So, if you're going to sum up this to 100 degrees, tsaka 80 degrees, then we're gonna have 180 degrees. So, that means we got correct answer since they are supplementary. Since they are considered same side interior angles. So, that's all for this video. Hopefully, you've learned a lot in this video and see you on our next video lesson. Alright? Thank you so much.